Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to train a semantic segmentation model using YOLO V8 and Google Colab. And this is exactly the notebook we are going to use in this process. You can see we have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps. So in only 5 steps, you will have completed this process and you will have trained your own semantic segmentation model using YOLO V8. Now, this is very important. This tutorial is only a very quick and a very high-level description of the entire process. If you want more details or if you want a much more comprehensive tutorial, then I invite you to take a look at other of my previous videos where I show you exactly how you need to prepare the data, how you need to annotate the data, how to train the model, and how to evaluate the model you trained. This other video, this other tutorial, is a much more comprehensive description of the entire process, so if you want more details, I definitely invite you to take a look at this other video, which I'm going to be posting over there. Now let's continue. Now let me show you something else, which is the Google Drive directory we are going to use in this project. You can see we have 3 files. One of them is config.yaml, then data.zip, and then train.ipynb. This file over here is the notebook in which we are going to be working in today, right? Train.ipynb is the notebook we are going to use in order to train this model. And then we also have these 2 other files. Now, it's very important you create a directory in your Google Drive in order to work on this project. You can see the directory I have created is located in my drive, Computer Vision Engineer, Semantic Segmentation, YOLO V8, Google Colab. That's the directory I have created in order to work on this project, but please remember to create a directory in your Google Drive, which is where you're going to upload all the data and all the files and so on. So please remember to create a directory in your Google Drive, and then I'm going to show you all the files you need to upload into this directory. Now, let me show you this file over here, which is data.zip. Let's go to my file system. You can see that this is the file I show you in my Google Drive, data.zip, and now let me show you how this file looks like. You can see we have 2 folders. One of them is called images, and the other one is called labels. Within the images directory, we have 3 additional directories. One of them is called test, the other one is called train, and the other one is called validation, and within each one of these directories is where we have all the data we are going to use in order to train the model. Now, let me show you how this data looks like. In my case, I am going to train a semantic segmentation model in order to detect ducks and alpacas. So you can see that all the images I have over here, they are about ducks and alpacas, right? Because these are the 2 categories I am going to detect with this model. Now, let's go back here to this other directory, which is called labels, and this is where we're going to locate all the labels, all the annotations we are going to use in order to train this model. Now, if you want a much more comprehensive description of how you need to prepare all these files which contain all the annotations, all the labels for this process, then I invite you to take a look at this tutorial over here, at these instructions which are in YOLO V8 official website, and these are the YOLO V8 official instructions on how you need to prepare all the annotations for this in order to train this model. Because if I show you how these files look like, you can see that they look very weird, right? We have many numbers, and this is a very long file, so in order to properly understand how to create each one of the files you need to locate here and within each one of these directories, then I invite you to take a very close look to these instructions which are provided by YOLO V8. Now, a very quick note, in my case, I have downloaded all this data from the Google Open Images Dataset version 7, from this website over here, which is the Google Open Images Dataset version 7. This is an amazing dataset. I have used it I don't know how many times, many times, an amazing dataset, but downloading this data was a very time-consuming process. So what I decided to do in order to help you to create your data to train your semantic segmentation model with YOLO V8 is to create a Python script which takes care of the entire process of downloading this data in a super easy way. The only thing you need to do in order to use this script is to edit these values over here, which are all the class names, all the categories you want to download from the Google Open Images Dataset version 7. In my case, I have selected these 2 class names, which are alpaca and duck, so this is why I have downloaded all the images and all the annotations for alpacas and ducks. But just replacing this these values for whatever other categories, whatever other class names you want, you will be able to use this script in order to download a semantic segmentation dataset from the Google Open Images dataset version 7. This is an amazing resource I created in order to help you to train this model, and this is a resource which is available in my Patreon. So it's going to be available to all my Patreon supporters. Now let's continue. Now let me show you something which is very important. You can see that although we have three directories over here, which are test, train, and validation, I am going to use only these two, which are train and validation. I am not going to use the data from this directory, which is the test directory. This is a very, very quick note. And now let's continue. So I'm only going to use these two, train and validation. Once you have created a dataset, once you have created a directory with all the data, which is formatted exactly like I show you over here, then the only thing you need to do is to zip this directory and to create this data.zip file. And once you have this file, the only thing you need to do is going back to your Google Drive and to upload this file into your directory, into your Google Drive. And that's it. And now let's get back to the Jupyter notebook we're going to use in order to train this model, because now it's time we start with this process. Now I'm going to execute absolutely every single cell in this notebook, and this is how we're going to train our semantic segmentation model. So I'm going to start executing this cell over here, which is going to mount my Google Drive into this Google Colab instance, right? I am going to connect Google Drive with Google Colab, and this is very important because we need to access all the data and all the files we have in this directory we have created in our Google Drive. So the only thing I'm going to do is to select my account and to click Allow. Okay, now our Google Drive is mounted into our Google Colab environment, and now we are ready to continue with the next step in this process, which is preparing the data. Or actually, this is going to be getting the data, getting this file, this data.zip file from our Google Drive into this instance, and then this is going to take care of unzipping this file and taking all the files which are within, right? So the only thing I'm going to do is to press enter, and this is going to take care of getting the file, getting the data.zip file, and then unzipping the file and unzipping all the content we have within this file. Okay, so we have extracted all the data we have within this file. We have extracted all the data in this environment, in this Google Colab environment. Now let's continue. Now the next step in this process is installing Ultralytics. Ultralytics is a Python library we are going to use in order to train this model with YOLO V8. So this is a very important library, and the only thing I'm going to do is to execute this cell. Now let's continue, and you can see we have already executed three steps in this process. We have only two steps left in order to train this model. This is amazing. And now the next step will be training the model. And in order to train the model, now I am going to show you this file, which is config.yaml, which is the other file we had in the directory in our Google Drive. So let me show you this file. This is a file with very important configuration in order to train this model. And if you have done everything as I show you in this tutorial so far, then you can just leave these three values as they are currently right now, and everything is going to work just fine. This is the location, the absolute location, the absolute path to your data, and this is the relative path, the relative location of your training images, and this is the relative location of your validation images. And when I say relative, I mean relative to this location over here, right? So long story short, if you have done everything as I show you in this tutorial, then you can just leave everything as it is right now, and everything is going to work just fine. Let me show you these two other keys we have over here, which are NC and names. NC stands for number of classes, and in my case I have two classes, so in my case this is two. And then this is a list of all the classes we are going to detect in this model. Remember, in my case I'm going to detect alpacas and ducks, so this is exactly how this looks like in my case for me. But please remember to update these two values with all the class names and all the number of classes you are going to detect with your model, right? So this is a very quick description of this file, which is config.yaml, and this is a very important file in order to continue. Something that's very important is that please remember to update this path over here with the path of the directory you have created in your Google Drive. Remember, in my case, this is my drive, Computer Vision Engineer, Semantic Segmentation, YOLO V8, Google Colab, which is exactly what I have over here. But in your case, please remember to update this directory, because otherwise this is not going to work, right? And the same goes for this other value over here. Please remember to update this directory, otherwise nothing is going to work. This should be the directory in your Google Drive, the directory you have created in your Google Drive. Now let's continue. Now the only thing I'm going to do is to execute this cell, and this is going to take care of the entire process, of the entire training process. So I'm just going to press enter, and then we need to wait for a few minutes, or actually for a few hours, until this process is completed. Okay, now the training process is completed, and this is all the output which was generated during the training process. You can see that this is a lot of information, and from all this information over here, we are going to mine this value, which is where all the data was saved, all the data we need in order to evaluate this model, and this is also where the weights we generated with this model, where the weights were trained, and everything is located here in runs segment train. So what we are going to do now is we are going to get all the data which was saved here in this directory, and we're going to copy this data into our Google Drive. This is very important, because this is going to make the process of downloading this data much easier. So what I'm going to do now is executing this cell, and this is going to take care of copying all this directory into my Google Drive. Okay, now going back to Google Drive, this is the directory we have just copied, and what I'm going to do now is to download this directory into my computer, into my file system. And now let me open this file so I can show you how it looks like. And basically this is where we are going to have all the images and all the data we need in order to evaluate this model. And also this is where we're going to have all the weights of the model we created. Now let me show you a couple of these images so I can show you how they look like. I'm going to open this image over here, which is Batch 0 Pred. And you can see that these are a few examples of how the model performs with a few images. So this is an image we can use in order to evaluate this model. Now let me open this other image, which is Ball Batch 1 Pred, and you can see that this is exactly the same. This is how the model performs with a few images. In this case we have images of ducks, and we also have images of alpacas, so this is a very good way to evaluate the model performance. These are images from the validation set, from the validation directory. Now let me open another directory with another image, which is Ball Batch 2 Pred, and this is exactly the same. This is how the model performs with a few images. Now in this video, this was, remember, a very quick and a very high level description of the entire process. I am not going into the details of the model evaluation. If you want more details on how to make sense of all the data we have over here within this file, then I invite you to take a look at this other video, this other tutorial, which is a much more comprehensive description of the entire process. And in this other video I show you how to evaluate the model and how to analyze all the information we have over here. So I definitely invite you to take a look at this other video, and this is going to be all for today. My name is Felipe, I'm a computer vision engineer, and see you on my next video.